I had just started cheerleading, and we thought that there was a muscle growing in my right thigh, and I had an MRI. The doctor said it was a tumor, so then we went to go meet Dr. K, and we did a biopsy, and it was cancerous.
What went through your mind when you heard that it was cancerous?
Oh God, am I gonna die? By second semester, I was not really going to school anymore, doing a lot of heavy chemo treatment and being sick all the time.
We ended up going in because her headaches were so severe and nothing would take them away, and she had an MRI on her brain, and we found out then that she had stage 4 metastatic melanoma. Totally different cancer than the cancer that was growing in the rest of her body. It's hard to even imagine how your child can get cancer, but then find out that your child has two cancers and they're not related and they're both stage 4 and neither one of them have good prognosis. It's just really a lot to deal with.
I've gone through several bone marrow biopsies and spinal taps. I got a football-sized tumor taken out of my leg, a softball-sized tumor taken out of my head, and I got the two lower lobes of my right lung removed because there was a tumor on them.
You just have to try to stay positive. Just have faith. I can't promise anything good, but I can definitely try to make them smile. And that's for today and not tomorrow. Oh, I'm 45 years old. Let me have it and let her live till she's 85. As a parent, I think you constantly pray for that, but it's a wish that probably will never come true.
She is just so strong. I look at her and I think that if she can do this, then I can be there for her.
I will stand by. I will help you through.
It's one of the hardest things you ever have to do is watch your child go through something like this. You just can't fix it. You can put band-aids on boo-boos when they're little and kiss away an owie, but
I will fight your
there's nothing that you can do about this as a parent. The Children's Hospital has done such an outstanding job. They are always there. The nurses are like family. We wouldn't ever do this kind of treatment anywhere else. It's such a wonderful place that if you can help support the Children's Miracle Network, they do such an outstanding job, and it would be so well worth your donation.
The staff has just been, the nurses, Dr. K. I wouldn't want to start naming names because I don't know who you would leave out.
I will stand by.
Because they are all just wonderful, wonderful, unbelievable place. So accommodating, so open, and so much like part of our family.
Cancer's come back in her lungs. She had a surgery the 20th of December to remove the two lower lobes of her lung. Currently, she's had a CAT scan on her chest, and there's now cancer in the left side of her lungs. The prognosis isn't good. When sarcoma comes back, it's generally so wild and rampant that it ends up taking your life. Now we're facing probably not such a good outcome. But Morgan wants to keep on fighting, and we're going to be right there to fight with her.